back to the Winter Season Showdowns, brought to you by MLG, where every single day, pretty much every single day, over the next few weeks at 5 p.m. Eastern, there's an epic best of five going on. Of course, every single player, 56 in total, trying to gain a spot at the Winter Championship event in Dallas, Texas on March 15th. Yesterday, we saw best of five between Parting and Fantasy. If you missed it, I feel a little bit sorry for you, but not that sorry for you, because it's available in 1080p HD right now on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/official MLG SC2. Again, if you missed it, go check it out. If you already saw it and you thought it was awesome, go drop a subscribe on the YouTube channel. I will love you forever, I promise. I'm plugging two things, but I want to do another plug to YouTube because I really am, I want to do this. Can we show my screen? Guys, you're doing great. We gained about 277 subscribers over the past, hour, which is phenomenal. Thank you so much for subscribing. Again, I'm trying to catch Call of Duty. They made it personal, and I'm taking it personally. They're at 8,600 subscribers. We're at 2,978. We're almost there. We can do it. Go to youtube.com/officialMLGSC2. Hit that subscribe button. I promise you won't regret it because you get to see me every single day because you get to click on the videos uploaded by officialMLGSC2. And I'm probably in most of them. Of course, you can catch the latest rules of engagement. We have some funny clips here. If you want to learn how to pick up chicks, I think there's a video in here as well regarding that. Comment of the Day, a new little series we're doing where I take a comment from the community, I talk about it, I tell you why you're wrong, I tell you why you're right, I give you my opinion, and I encourage you to comment. So go check that out as well. Of course, VODs from previous Heart of the Swarm exhibitions, top 10s and top 5s, epic stuff. Also, do you want an awesome gaming house? Facebook.com/MLGPro. If you said no, you probably already have an awesome gaming house, or you don't have enough money to do it, but guess what? We're giving you that opportunity. We want to set you up. We want to hook you up big time. You want that dream land. You want to be that guy who's at the lunch table who's like, I have this awesome gaming setup. I got a LAN party. Come over this weekend. Bring some girls. Bring some Dr. Pepper. Let's hang out and let's play some games. This is your opportunity. Facebook.com/MLGPro. Dr. Pepper Ultimate Gaming House. Go there. Click here and fill out this application. It's not too hard to do if you have a smartphone. You gotta take a video, but it's gotta be no more than 5 minutes in length. Introduce yourself, your friend, or your group. Tell us why you or they deserve the Ultimate Gaming House. Show us the room or area you want to see transformed, and tell us how you are a one-of-a-kind fan of Dr. Pepper and MLG. The contest ends on February 15th. Plenty of time to throw something together and get yourself an Ultimate Gaming House, brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Also, MLG Pro Shop, awesome place. I have some swag I wanna show y'all. Reach down here, not a minute. Boom! Check out this bag. If you want this bag, you can't have this one, but if you want one like it, there's lots of room. If you are a track athlete and you want somewhere to put your shoes or your clothes, you're going to the gym a lot. Oh, it's so perfect. It has MLG on it. You can show your friends. Look, I got an MLG bag. We also got, oh, these are sick. We got Gunners, MLG Pro Shop. I probably don't look too good in them because I'm ugly, but yeah. Gunners, MLGProShop.com. You can get all this stuff. Of course, they don't really fit well with my headset, but that's okay. We got a backpack that's currently stuck underneath my chair, so you're gonna take my word on it. But if we can show my screen really quick, MLGProShop.com. We got t-shirts, hoodies, Nike merchandise, and a bunch of stuff. So check that out ASAP. That being said, I'm done plugging stuff. I know y'all are ready to get into the next game, so let's go ahead and do it. This is going to be game four between Roro and Hero. Unfortunately, Mr. Axelab is feeling a little bit under the weather, so he won't be joining me for this one. I hope he's okay. I hope you guys hope he's okay. Send him your kind regards. Tweet at him, at ISAxelab. You can tweet at me if you feel like it, at AxelTos. Also, if you want to join in on the conversation, if you want to say stuff about these players, if you have strong opinions on the game, head on over to reddit.com/r/starcraft. There's a Reddit thread there where you can have a nice, jolly conversation with the other individuals there. Also, there's a Team Liquid thread. If Reddit isn't your cup of tea, you can head on over to the Team Liquid thread and join in on the conversation there. That being said, here we are in game number four. Top right-hand location, we have the Red Zerg player who's currently up 2-1. He is one win away from advancing to the MLG Winter Championships in Dallas, Texas on March 15th. Of course, I'm so happy you guys are subscribing to the YouTube. There's a beta key down there for the taking, so please take advantage. If you want more beta keys to be spammed on the screen, do your part. It's not, I'm not asking for much. Just go subscribe to the YouTube channel. It's not that hard to do. But yeah, that's for you guys, from me. All right, so yeah, Roro, he's one win away. If he wins this game, you're going to see him in Dallas, Texas at the Winter Championship event. In the bottom left-hand location, one of my personal favorite players from CJ Entis. He is Hero, a very handsome-looking guy, very classy individual. Got a little bit of fame for that game against Stefano, where they both broke a little bit of rulage, but he was very polite about it. He had a smile on his face, and so did Stefano. He has to win two more in a row, which is going to be tough. These are two of the best players in the world, without a doubt. Aces of their respective teams, some might argue. Of course, Hero has very nice results in Pro League, so does Roro. Roro, of course, previously beating Flash in the ace match for Samsung Khan. Game 3 was an epic 40-minute-ish ordeal between these two players. We saw Tempests, we saw Infestors, we saw Broodlords, we saw about 25 Overseers. If you missed it, again, the VOD will be available in full 1080p high definition in about an hour or so. All right, let's see what happens here. The map is Planet S. Now, this is a pretty unique map. Let's talk about it a little bit, because I know some people might be unfamiliar. In fact, this is the first map. This is the first time I've casted a game on this map, but it looks exciting to me. We've got a natural expansion. Decent choke point here. We see a gateway in production. We got, I guess the third base would be either here up this ramp or here on the left-hand side, a little meander around this Game of Thrones type wall. We got some gold bases in the middle. Those are gonna be important as this game goes along, I'm sure. And we have Roro already taking his third base. Not too surprising. Very standard Zerg style. No gas is taken just yet. I'm interested to see how these players are going to adjust, not only based on Heart of the Swarm, but based on that last game. Will Hero try to go for Tempest a little bit faster? Will he get more Void Rays on the field? I feel like he had the resources to get a pretty scary army, but he might have been a little bit late in his transition. Remember, he spent a lot of gases on High Templars, on Archons. I'm not sure how cost-efficient Archons can be in Heart of the Swarm late game, considering the Vortex no longer exists on the Mothership. Now imagine if Hero, instead of using that gas on those Archons, if he spent that gas on those additional Stargates a little bit earlier. If he spent that gas on additional Cybercore a little bit earlier. If he spent that gas on additional Cybercore air upgrades, armor slash weapons. Then he could have a pretty ferocious army. So, should be interesting to see what these two players do. Ooh, we have a Twilight Council. We also have plus one ground weapons. Now, DTs are a little bit easier to get. Only 150 gas versus the 250 gas from Wings of Liberty. Hero already has four gases fully saturated. Actually, this one has two out of three. Now one out of three. So we'll keep an eye on this. He's already at 300 gas. Meanwhile, speed is on the way here from Roro. Let's see if he can scout what's going on. It is going to be Blink from CJ's Hero. Of course, the third is pretty far away from the natural expansion. You've got to get the creep up there as fast as possible. Connect those so it's easier for units to meander in between them and defend them, of course. Five additional gateways on the way. Hero, he's not messing around. He won game one. Roro won the next two games. Hero wants to bring it back, wants to tie it up. Blink Stalker all in might be the way to do it with the Mothership Core to supplement. It's like, you know what? I don't want to go late game against this guy. He's too darn good. Broodlords and Infestors are pretty good as well. Of course, supplemented by those Corruptors. He couldn't figure it out in the last game. He's going to try to end it early here. No probes in production. That's very important. I mean, just extremely less likely for Hero to take an expansion unless this attack fails or unless this attack isn't able to kill Roro, in which case he'd kind of be forced to take that expansion. Already coming across the map here. He might take down this Overlord. This is going to be very, very close. No, this Overlord is going to fall to those three Stalkers. Roro going to be reacting, making a lot of links in that production tab. Speed is about to finish. Let's go to the income tab. 42. Oh, wow. 55 harvesters on the field for Roro. Is that going to be enough to defend this Blink Stalker attack? Keep in mind, there is a Mothership Core here involved. Keep in mind, it can also use the Time Roll. But see, if Hero decides to utilize that, the Stalker is coming back here. The Blink is not yet done. He wants Blink to finish with the Blink away. Blink is so... There we go. Blink is now done. Hero starting to methodically blink back those Blink Stalkers. But is it enough? Roro has so many units on the field. 102. He knew this was coming. Four Overlords in production. Mothership Core desperately trying to keep these pylons alive. But his push from Hero looking worse and worse. Gonna try to backpedal here. Gonna try to set up a concave to deal with these roaches and these links. And now he's gonna be the one in pursuit. So if he can blink forward and take out some roaches, that would be a great thing. But heads up, you don't got high ground vision. At the top of that ramp, bringing back that Mothership Core to see what damage can be done. He could Time Warp here. Look out for that. The Stalker's going to be engaging. Blinking back is Hero. Each weakened Stalker, Roro trying to engage with all these Lings and these Roaches. Is that going to be enough? No, it looks like Hero's going to back away, trying to methodically blink once again. Roro is now on the pursuit with all these Speedlings and Roaches. Roro looking very good. 94 to 61 is his supply advantage. Can he make this happen right here, right now? 32 Lings in production. Hero is on his back foot. Keep in mind, he has no third. He stopped making probes a long time ago. Roro is at 54 Harvesters to his opponent's 41. Hero can evacuate into his main base. Gonna try to stay alive for now, but when you're doing, look at these links, look at that blood trail from those links, that's insane. Anyway, when you're doing a blink all in and your opponent is the one pressuring you, it's generally not a good thing. Roro looking great in this game number four. Again, if he wins this, he gets a spot at the championship event in Dallas, Texas on March 15th. Hero turning around some Stalkers here, trying to engage this. Link's gonna try to come forward and get some damage done on those Stalkers. Hero might have to blink back behind this wall. Look at this. Now Roro's going to be the one retreating. And slowly but surely, Hero is closing that supply gap. Roro is still making nothing but Lings and Roaches. Has three queens in production. And now Hero's going to go to the top side of the map with these Stalkers, trying to take advantage of all the units he just killed. Units lost tab shows. 4106, excuse me, to 2400. So Hero well ahead in that regard. Units tab shows. 51 drones to 41 probes. Hero coming forward with 21 Stalkers and a Mothership Core, only 8 Roaches and 30 Lings here to defend from Roro. Gonna turn around, trying to engage. There is creep there. It will help a little bit. There's 3 Queens here, not a lot of energy in between them. Hero starting off with the Blink Stalker Micro, keeping those Blink Stalkers away, the weakened ones at least. The Zeld coming forward. There's the Time Warp onto the Roaches, and Hero trying to make a comeback happen, and it might work. Roro does not have a lot of units left, only Roaches and Queens. They're getting slowed by those Time Warps. I didn't think Queens could move any slower, but Time Warps can make anything happen. The Stalker's gonna be backing away. Roro still with more Lings, more Roaches in production, trying to fend this attack off, realizes how important this match is for himself, for his team, for his family, for his country, for the Zerg race. But can Hero close him out, or at least pull this into a game number five? Gonna be trying to engage into that third base. 3 spines at the top there. Great decision there from Roro. But now, does he have enough defenses at this natural? Hero coming forward, but can Hero blink back? Can he retreat? Yes, he can. He found a spot where there is no flank. Roach is trying to engage here. Hero now is very close to getting that supply lead for the first time in this game, or at least after his initial push. Can Roro hold this off? Hero has so many units here, so many Stalkers that he's blinking back, being so cost efficient. +2 on the weapons upgrade. Only like 5 Queens remain, and they're slowly but surely dying. 51 drones still in the field, but only 2 Roaches, only 8 Lings. What does Roro have? He has nothing. Roro able to pull a win out of that game. That was phenomenal. Roro did a great job holding off that initial push. Able to shove him back. He's like, God, I'm not sure. You got some Stalkers? Okay, I have Lings. I have Roaches. I have Queens. I'll take that out. Hero had to back away slowly but surely. Started adding on more Stalkers. Started isolating units here and there. Started picking off Roaches, picking off Lings. Blinked into his main to protect the weakened Stalkers. Kept it up with the Blink Stalker Micro. Didn't say, all right, went behind Dark Shrine, said, went behind, I'm going to micro like a boss. And that's exactly what he did. Hero able to get micro those Blink Stalkers perfectly, able to mount a counterattack. Roro was still stuck on Lings and Roaches, not the tech you want to be on necessarily against a large amount of +2 Blink Stalkers, but 3 spines at his third base, but left his natural expansion completely exposed. Hero able to take advantage, able to lay down some genius Time Warps, and able to take down Roro in game number 4, which means we have a game 5 coming up. These players are tied 2-2. Roro and Hero, the winner of the next game, will get a spot at the championship event in Dallas, Texas on March 15th. Don't go anywhere.